last class I have not recorded, so you will see notes from your friends. Okay, so synchronous generator. Okay, so what is the job? Why we are using synchronous generator here? To supply reactive power. Okay, to control the voltage. Okay, so to control the voltage, so what is the expression for reactive power? Q. Okay, so what is the expression for reactive power at the receiving end side? Okay, so what is this? B of E divided by X cos delta minus V square by X. Okay, this expression we have seen for such transmission line. Okay, so this is the transmission line here. Reactance is Jx, voltage is this voltage is E angle delta. Okay, E angle delta, and this is V angle zero. Okay, in that case we have derived reactive power this expression. Okay, so if I little bit simplify, this is V by X. Okay, and then E cos delta minus V. Okay, so this is what reactive power. Okay, and you know if Q is positive, Q is positive, it means it is lagging power factor, reactive power, or we can say deliver, or it is what? If Q is positive, it is lagging Q. Okay, okay. Is tarah ki lagging Q, which one provide lagging Q? Capacitor. Capacitor has capability to provide lagging reactive power. Okay, and if this is negative, then this is leading Q. Okay, so this is what it is delivering, leading Q. Okay, and just reverse, if I reverse it, this is leading minus Q. The same sentence, if this is I am writing Q is positive, I can also write leading minus Q. That you have to understand. Okay, so when this Q is positive, when this term is positive, more. Okay, so first case, there are three possibility. First one is E cos delta is greater than V. Second possibility, E cos delta equal to V. And third possibility is E cos delta is less than V. So what is this? In this case, Q is positive. It means it will deliver lagging Q. It have capability. It can deliver positive Q. Positive Q means it can deliver lagging reactive power. Okay, this is what lagging Q. Okay, so it can turn, in this case generator work as a lagging power factor one. If this is zero, this is equal to, then Q is zero. So there is a unity power factor. Your generator is working at unity power factor. It means it will not deliver reactive power. In this case, what will happen? If this is greater, then this is negative. So Q is negative. So we can say it can deliver. I'm telling you, this is what? Positive, that's why lagging Q. But this is delivering negative Q. So it can deliver leading okay, because Q is negative, so it can deliver leading Q. Okay, so in that way your generator, synchronous generator, will work. Now next is synchronous motor. Okay, so what about synchronous motor? The same way we can also understand synchronous motor. So what about synchronous motor? The synchronous motor has just reverse operation of this. So next is synchronous motor. Initially what happens, the current direction, suppose this is generator, okay, so it is supplying current, okay, this is in case of generator, but in case of current direction will reverses, okay, so current direction will change, okay, it means it will take current, and this is also change, because in case of motor, okay, you have to remember, this is suppose terminal voltage, okay, this is your E, so in this case your this E is lagging, okay, that's why this is what case, this is the case of motor, and suppose this is leading, E is leading by an angle, then this case is generator case, because in case of generator it is supplying power, that's why induced EMF is leading with respect to terminal voltage in case of generator, but in case of motor this induced EMF is lagging, okay, that's why we are placing, this is because lagging, so we are placing negative sign here, okay, so if I do it, then we have a one sign change here, this is negative, this is plus, okay, so this will become negative, this will become plus, okay, so all the cases will change, okay, what will change here in first case, in this case this term is greater, in that case Q is what, negative, okay, so Q is negative, it means motor is delivering leading Q, okay, or since motor is absorbed, okay, so what is the case, this if E is greater than this magnitude of E, okay, so also remember this is the magnitude, okay, I am writing this E and B both are magnitudes, okay, remember it in first case also, so in that case Q is what, negative, okay, so what is the meaning of this, since motor is taking power, okay, from the electrical supply source, so this is the case of Q is negative, it means Q is leading, leading means this is what, under excitation or over excitation, so this is the case of over excitation, because Q is negative, okay, so Q is negative in case of leading power factor, that means over excitation case, so Q is less than 0 means negative, that's why motor absorb leading Q, okay, so we can say motor absorb leading Q or deliver lagging Q, okay, next case equal, in that case motor is operate at unity power factor. In this case this is greater, so Q is positive. So just reverse case happened here. This is what under excitation case. Okay, this is under excitation case. So what will happen? Motor absorb lagging Q or deliver leading Q. So this is a case of under excitation. In this case, this is what? This is called normal excitation. Okay. So this is about the synchronous motor. Okay. Now next topic is synchronous condenser. Okay. So what is a synchronous condenser? Is nothing but a synchronous motor which is operating at no load condition. Okay, so now next topic is synchronous condenser. Okay, so now let me see what is synchronous condenser. So right, it is a dynamic compensator. Synchronous condenser. So what is the synchronous condenser? Same as we did. So synchronous condenser is nothing but there is a generator. If I am writing here this way, it means this is a generator, but condenser, so this is a motor. So this is a motor which is operating at no load. Okay, and we will also see what is the difference. And there is a line reactance, then there is a terminal voltage. Okay, we have Jx. So we have seen this. Okay, so what are the difference? It is characterized by a large synchronous reactance. So this is what, suppose this is a synchronous reactance, then this synchronous reactance will be large. In case of synchronous condenser as compared to synchronous motor. So this is the first modification. Second one is heavy field winding. Okay, synchronous condenser have heavy field winding. Okay, means field winding rating is high as compared to synchronous motor. So these are the two modification, and it is also develop zero power factor leading current. Okay, so let me see the characteristic of machine. Okay, synchronous motor. So we have seen synchronous motor drawn between B curve, drawn between what? Field current versus is visible. No, I am drawing little bit. Okay, so you have noted. Okay, now I am drawing characteristic. Okay, so this is what field current. I thought it is not visible. Now it is visible. Okay, so this is a field current. Here is reactive power. Okay, or Q, or we can say power factor. So what kind of characteristic we are getting about the synchronous motor? Okay, since field winding is heavy of the synchronous condenser, okay, so it will require very less current to generate flux. Okay, so if you see the characteristic of synchronous condenser, it will look like B curve like. Okay, so this is like this, or we can say this is like little bit like that. Okay. And synchronous motor characteristic is like, because it's a field current is field means synchronous reactance is less as compared to synchronous condenser, so its characteristic like this. Red is visible. Okay, I thought visible it is. Okay, so what is the maximum rating of this? Is like this. Okay, so it will like. So I will use again this. Okay. So this is the maximum value. Okay. And if I will take it, it is approximately 0.8. Okay. Then this is very less, 0.2, 0.4, 0. Okay. This is a per unit field current. Okay. So this is like 1.2. Here is somewhere bound. So you can see this is the characteristic B curve of condenser, and this is the B curve of synchronous motor. So you can see, because of the heavy field winding, it will require very less field current to generate Q. To generate the field lines, Q means field lines, okay, inductive effect. Okay, so you can see the difference between motor and condenser and motor characteristic. Okay, so this is a synchronous motor, this is synchronous condenser. Okay, so these are the B curve for synchronous motor and condenser. Okay, this is what B curve for synchronous motor and synchronous condenser. Okay, so what is the difference between synchronous motor and synchronous condenser? It will operate at low, it will operate at no load. That's why it is used for the power factor correction. Okay, so here is the leading, this is what, this line shows unity power factor, this is lagging. So if I will give field current below 0.2 or 0.2 per unit, then it will operate at lagging power factor. Here it will operate at leading power factor. At this point, it will operate at unity power factor. Okay. So, if I want to initially operate our machine, at some point, okay. So now let me see the characteristic of operating characteristic of synchronous condenser, this part. So this is what, this is lagging side, lagging, this is what, this side is leading for synchronous condenser, and for synchronous motor this is lagging, this is leading. Okay, so you can see synchronous condenser required very less field current, okay, as compared to synchronous motor. Okay, due to high synchronous reactance of the synchronous condenser and heavy field winding. Now let me see operating characteristic of synchronous condenser. So what are the operating characteristic of synchronous condenser? So let us see. Okay, suppose this is a voltage. Okay, and here is BAR, or we can say Q, okay? Reactive BAR. This case we are having a leading power factor. This case, this direction we have a lagging, lagging VAR. Okay, at this point we have a unity power factor. Okay, or normal excitation. So if you draw a load line, then you see at leading side your voltage will increase. Okay? So if I plot two load line, then you can see this is one load line. Okay, and this one is second load line. Okay, so I am plotting, but slope is more. This is not the practical case. I will take little bit more. Okay, so this is the case. Okay, so this is a load line. This is also load line. Let this is load line one. This is load line two. Okay. And our motor is operating suppose at point A. Okay. This is the point at which our motor is operating. Okay. So this is the point at which our motor is operating. This is a point A, and let the rated value is like this. Okay. I will little bit extend it. B, and let rated value is this. Okay. So this is what rated. Machine rating is at this point. Okay. Now, due to some change in voltage, machine is not operating at this point. Okay. Due to some reason, machine will operate at this point. Okay, so this is what rating of this load line 2. Okay, due to some reason your this machine is operating somewhere like here. Okay, somewhere here. Okay, so initial operating point is C. Sorry, D. Now this is operating at C. Since you are operating at this point and load line, this is rated value of the machine is shifted to point A. In that case, you can see this value is going to increase. Okay. This is what lagging VAR. So lagging VAR increases, okay, which is not desirable. So your machine is initially operating at point A. Due to sudden voltage drop, this delta V voltage drop, your this machine, this line is shifted to this. So this will going beyond this rated point, because this is the rated point of second line load line. So it is shifted to C, okay, which is not desirable. So due to this sudden drop in voltage delta V, our motor rotor will swing, and as this D point going beyond this rating, so it will in anyhow we have to shift to this point. Okay, this change will happen only for fraction of second. If it will going for large duration, then our machine will damage. Okay, so it will not allow to change for a large time. Okay, this change may happen for a very short duration of time, and then again this will return to this point. Okay, after this point. Okay, So we can't go beyond this rated depth. Okay. So this is a way of, or we can say, characteristic of the synchronous condenser. Okay. So what are these? These are the characteristics of, or we can say, operating characteristic of synchronous condenser. Okay, so these are the operating characteristic of synchronous condenser. Here, okay, so this is the difference between synchronous motor and condenser. Okay, in next class we will see the internal excitation control and midpoint compensation. Okay, any question from your side? Okay, thank you. So we will meet in next class.